Given that he was one of the two most powerful individuals within the galaxy, and the primary agent who would act as the enforcer of Emperor Palpatine's will within the Empire, one would think that Darth Vader had to be known by the average galactic citizen, a fearsome consequence for anyone who went against the Emperor and the Empire. Combined with the popularity of the character, and the fact that Vader's featured in so many stories within the lore, it's hard to imagine that Vader wasn't known to practically everyone in the galaxy. However, as it exists within the current canon, Vader wasn't well known to the average citizen of the Empire. And I don't mean this in the sense that they didn't understand his true origins and connections to the Jedi and Anakin Skywalker, which only a handful of individuals truly understood. What I mean is that Vader's existence itself, and certainly what he was capable of with the Force, wasn't known throughout the Empire, where Vader was rarely recognizable as a public figure to the average galactic citizen. This would be the result of Vader's master, Darth Sidious, who wanted it that way within the current canon materials. We'll start by explaining why Sidious intentionally hid Vader and his full powers and abilities from the public eye, and then we'll look at how this current canon lore for Darth Vader was treated in an entirely opposite way within the Legends lore. Sidious's intention to keep Vader and his abilities from the knowledge of the average Imperial citizen is revealed in the canon reference guide, Star Wars Propaganda, A History of Persuasive Art in the Galaxy. As the era of the Empire proceeded, Sidious himself would begin to reduce his own visibility from public view, with the decision-making process being widely overseen by the Imperial Council, consisting of Sidious's circle of advisors and military leaders. But while he would certainly keep his own Sith identity and abilities with the Force hidden, Emperor Palpatine was always the face of the Empire. The same can't be said for Vader. He wasn't part of the Empire's propaganda pieces, and his true role within the Imperial hierarchy wasn't well known until his death after the Galactic Civil War. As Star Wars propaganda makes clear, to the general population of the galaxy, Vader wasn't seen or understood as a public figure. This was completely intentional on the part of Sidious. As Emperor, he ordered his advisors to keep his apprentice from the public eye and to not use him as a symbol for the Empire. Sidious saw Vader, and by extension, the Inquisitors that comprise Vader's Inquisitorius, as tools of the Emperor rather than tools of the Empire. But even more importantly, Vader, like the Emperor within his Sith identity, was far too connected to the Force, or as Sidious thought the galaxy would see it, esoteric spiritual matters of an ancient religion. For Sidious, Vader's connection to the Force put them at risk, as it threatened to place them within the realm of the Jedi, who were of course by that time viewed as dangerous and treacherous. Therefore, at the orders of the Emperor, Vader's abilities with the Force and his use of a lightsaber were not generally demonstrated to the galaxy at large, making him a surprisingly unknown figure to Imperial citizens. Of course, it wasn't as if Vader was completely unknown. Given his important role, his existence was far more well known within the galaxy's core worlds, and unsurprisingly, his reputation within the Imperial Army and Navy grew as the Imperial era went on, especially in the aftermath of the Battle of Yavin, when he was unleashed upon the rebellion. And when it fit the campaign needs of the Empire, Vader's image was used in isolated examples, mainly on Imperial academies within the core worlds. It's hard to imagine Vader and his abilities not being well known throughout the Galactic Empire, but I think there are two examples from within the canon that demonstrate Sidious's orders in this way. The first is in issue number 12 of the 2017 Darth Vader comic, where we see two elite Imperial officers discussing the fact they had no idea who Darth Vader was. Although this occurred within the early period of the Empire, it wasn't as if it was in its earliest days or weeks. Months had gone by, and yet these important figures still didn't know whether Vader was some type of bodyguard or otherwise, and they were so unaware of his true power and abilities, they foolishly made repeated attempts on his life. When Sidious finally did allow Vader to demonstrate his power before a large group of elite officers to end the assassination attempts, Vader's wrath against five officers wasn't broadcast to the galaxy or recorded for others in the Imperial military to see. It happened behind closed doors on Coruscant, with Sidious merely telling the elite officers of the Empire to pass down what they saw to those they commanded, demonstrating that Vader's abilities weren't to be seen by the general public and were to be established mainly through his ever-increasing reputation. A second example is seen in the same Vader series a few issues later in issue number 20. After Vader unleashed his fury on two Inquisitors, utterly destroying a large section of Coruscant as he hunted them down, Sidious was furious, explaining that Vader's actions threatened his seat of power by appearing as though the Emperor couldn't maintain order there. Sidious would want the appearance of order, but given the information within the Star Wars propaganda guide, I don't think it's surprising that following the extremely public display of destruction by Vader and the Inquisitors, the Emperor would move the Inquisitorius' headquarters off of Coruscant to the outer rim moon of Nur, while supporting Vader's move to his fortress on Mustafar. With Sidious wanting Vader's abilities with the Force kept from the public eye, it makes sense why he would want Vader and the Inquisitors off of Coruscant. The interesting aspect to this canon lore is that Sidious treated Vader in the exact opposite way within Legends. In a recent video, we discussed how the Empire turned Vader into a galactic hero, using him in propaganda pieces that demonstrated his use of a lightsaber and the Force just like Jedi and Sith did, despite it having obvious connections to these ancient religions. In fact, as seen within the novel Dark Lord: The Rise of Darth Vader, Sidious intentionally revealed Vader to the entire galaxy, only months into the Empire. The novel shows that Vader was to have a different role for Sidious within Legends. While Sidious would still hide his allegiances to the Sith and use of the dark side, as he did within the current canon, Vader was an outward extension of Sidious's power and a fearsome embodiment of the dark side, with Sidious literally referring to his apprentice as his Crimson Blade. Obedience within the Empire was to be established through fear, and for this, Vader was Sidious's primary agent, with mere rumors of Vader's presence enough to garner conformity. In Legends, Sidious didn't care if the galaxy viewed Vader as a fallen Jedi or resurfaced Sith. When Tarkin approached the Emperor in the early months of the Empire, concerned that Vader was being viewed as a former Jedi or Sith apprentice to Dooku, the only thing that concerned Sidious was that Vader's commands be obeyed and that he be feared. And to reach such a position, the galaxy had to be aware of his apprentice and know his true power and abilities. So there we have it, why Palpatine hid Vader's full powers and abilities from the galaxy within canon. Thank you very much to all of the Patreon members of Star Wars Reading Club, as your support is so greatly appreciated. You can find all of our social media links and a link to our Star Wars gaming channel in the description below for updates and even more Star Wars content. We love making these videos, so why not subscribe for more fun Star Wars theories and discussions? Also, if you enjoyed the video, think about giving a like or leaving a comment. If not for me... For, but most of the time he can.